Hey everybody, this is Doug with Artfully Road. And so I've got a big project coming up. I'm gonna do a lot of welding. A lot of welding means a lot of smoke. So in order to get rid of that smoke, I need to build an extractor fan that pulls the smoke out of my shop. So as opposed to spending thousands on a high-end smoke extractor, I'm gonna build one from scratch using parts at my local hardware store.
I started with an attic fan, a 12-inch to 10-inch adapter, a 10-inch to 8-inch adapter, and an 8-inch to 6-inch adapter, and a 25 feet of 6-inch flexible ducting, and a 6-inch 90, and 5 foot of 6-inch solid duct. So I started by making the metal bracket that would support the fan when mounted to the shop wall. This bracket attaches directly to the fan. The support bracket needed to swing into place when in use and then swing out of the way so I could actually close the roll-up door. Although the fan wasn't real heavy, I made sure to add a few gussets to support the bracket and the weight that it would take on. So now it's ready for a test fit. The fan diameter was 15 inches, so I needed to reduce the opening to 12 so I can attach the first reducer. Cutting the tabs allows for better fit between the fan and the first reducer. Once I pushed all of these tabs down, I went ahead and added a few self-tapping screws to hold it in place. Placing the reducer on top of the fan and basically doing the same thing that I did to the reducer, and then adding some self-tapping screws. Once all the tabs were down and a few screws installed, then I added tape all around the seams to prevent any loss of airflow. Once that was done, I was able to work on the next two adapters. This brought me down to the 6 inches that would then get me to the flexible ducting. So this is the actual fan and the reducers all set up in place. And then this is a better shot of the bracket that I made. I had a hard time getting some shots because of all the metal that was in there. So now I'm making the bracket for the 5 foot solid duct. Because I actually want this to twist left and right and to be able to tilt up and down, I made that funky little contraption there. And then I often use just parts that I have laying around in my shop to build the things that I do. So now trying to attach the solid ducting. I think one more hand here would have been a bit helpful. Just adding some self-tapping screws on the side to hold it in place. It's not very heavy at all. And then I used some hose clamps to attach the flexible ducting to the 90. And now for the electrical side. Basic parts, a couple of junction boxes, some plates, a switch. Choose the knockouts that you're going to use. I always knock out all the knockouts first so that they're knocked out. And then you want to make sure that you add the strain reliefs into the junction boxes. The strain relief is designed to protect the cable and keep it from coming out of the junction box. Here I actually have two different styles. One is a quick fit, and the other one, as you see here, is a threaded type. Both are the same, just different styles. And then I had some cord left over from a tool that broke years ago, and now I'm finding new use for the cord. Run it through the box, and then pull up maybe about 6 or 7 inches of that cord, And then you want to cut away that outer sheath and expose the wires that are inside of that sheath. Next, you want to cut your black wire or your hot line, pretty much just right in the middle. And then with a pair of wire strippers, you want to be able to take off about 3/4 of an inch on each side of that black line. Once you have the exposed wire, go ahead and give the wire a good twist so that all the wires stay together. And then screw that down nice and tight. And you'll do that to the other side. Basically, that switch breaks that current. Now I'm using a concrete drill to go into the block, and I'm going to use tap-con screws to go into the concrete block as well. I mount the junction box and then go ahead and put the switch onto the junction box. I could have hardwired this into the plug, which is directly below this switch. I just chose not to, so I used the plug that's coming out of this switch, and now I just plug it into the outlet that's directly below here. So that provides my power. So this had a thermostat on it, and I don't want to use a thermostat, so I'm taking the wires going directly to the fan and cutting everything else out, putting that into the new box, and then wiring those together with the electrical cord that I just ran through the switch. And now the final step. Turn on the fan, and you're going to hear this audio so you can see how loud it is. It actually sounds a little louder here in the video than it really is. I was really surprised at how quiet it was in the shop. So that was really a nice feature. The fan was not loud. I will probably add a protective shroud. That way nothing gets in there. The ducting is kind of temporary. I want to see if I like it. I might go to a solid tube the entire way. So that's why that was just kind of hanging by ropes. But let's see the test. And as you can see, it sucks the smoke right into there. I was really, really pleased at how much this eliminated the smoke in my shop.
Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. It is greatly appreciated. If you aren't already subscribed, now is a great time to do that. Push that subscribe button. If you're already subscribed and you'd like to be notified when my videos come out, hit that bell icon and you'll get notifications. And don't forget to comment. I appreciate the comments. I love the interaction. If you have suggestions or you want to say, hey, that's great too, I try to hit all my comments. We'll see you in the next video.